So Advent is a time of preparation and a time of journey. And the journey isn't always very easy. We began in the time of Isaiah, the readings of Isaiah 3 weeks ago, and Isaiah's people were recognizing that they were feeling rather separated from God, and that God wasn't really happy with the way they were being. And we probably were given some pause to recognize that we are not always the people that God would have us be, that we don't always do those things that God would have us do, and we don't always lead those righteous lives that God would most desire for us to lead. And so upon the heels of that, we come to last week and we meet John the Baptist, the wild man of great renown in the wilderness, calling out, "Repent and believe." And we go out there and we hear him calling and yelling for people to turn their lives around. This is the opportunity that he had been sent to prepare the way for the Lord, because the Messiah was coming. And so he was to get the people ready, to get them turned around so that they would be able to follow and go the way that God would have them go. And we too know that we can choose to make our lives ready to follow the way of the Lord, because although the Messiah did come in their time, we too are waiting. We are waiting for Jesus to return. And so we too are faced with many wilderness times in our lives. We're faced with those times in which we encounter those dark times, those times of uncertainty in which we lose our jobs and we lose loved ones and we lose our marriages and we lose friendships and we lose our sense of joy and hopefulness and we seem lost and we really want to know what it is that we're supposed to be doing in our lives so that our lives might be the way we expect them to be. You know, if we're good Christians coming to church, why aren't we feeling better? And we were reminded that we can choose to live as followers of Jesus Christ. And if we choose to live as followers of Jesus Christ, what we're choosing to live as people who choose to love as God loves. And if we choose to love as God loves, that means we love others with the same unconditional love that God loves them. And that we don't put all those barriers between us and them. We just love and do that wonderful giving and kindness and mercy and forgiveness and peacefulness and just pour it out. And so that was our challenge for last week, that we were just going to love others as God loves us. And I hope you took the challenge, and I hope you had those opportunities to demonstrate to others the love that you receive and spread that in all the places you went. And so today we encounter the letter from Paul to the people in Thessalonica. And Thessalonica was the capital of Macedonia. And this was the very first letter of the New Testament letters. If you need some Christmas Day trivia, that's one. I don't know how it'll wow your family members, but it was the very first letter written. And so when you think about the first letter that a church planter is going to write to one of his new churches, you think about, what is he going to say? You know, it's probably going to be a good cheerleading letter. It's going to be something that's going to boost them up and encourage them so that they can go out and make new members and get everybody all geared up to just keep them fired up and doing the good work of Jesus Christ, and what he wants to talk about is joy. Well, that's an excellent title, but what he wants to talk about is joy in conflict. Ooh. But see, the people in that time were experiencing kind of what we experience in times like these. Their security was a little unsettled, to say the least. They had come to know the love of Jesus Christ through Paul. Paul had explained to them about this wonderful person who had come to save them. Because what we heard last week, if you remember, that Mark starts, in the first chapter of Mark starts, that this is the beginning of the good news of Jesus Christ, God's Son. So we got the whole thing right up front, and he came to save us. you know, right in the beginning, we get the whole thing. And so we would know how to lead our lives from that moment forward. And so this was the kind of good news that Paul was going and spreading out amongst all the people in the Gentile world, because he was the Gentile, the apostle to the Gentiles. And so he's out there spreading this good news and telling them how Jesus was going to, had come and to save his people, and that he was going to return, and their lives were going to be so much better. And so people were expecting him to come any moment. But in this meantime, he wasn't here. And in this meantime, they were losing some of their family members. And in this meantime, they were grieving, and they didn't know what was going to happen to these people that just died. And if Jesus was supposed to come back and swoop them all up and everything was going to be great and these people were dying, what was going to happen to them? And, you know, when we think about all these things that we don't know the answer to right now, you know, if you turn on the news for 2 minutes, you don't even have to have it on for five, you know, then everybody's worried about taxes and everybody's worried, you know, and there's all these concerns about how the nature of the world is. Are we going to go to war? Are we going to have the government collapse? All this uncertainty going on, and how do we find this joy in the middle of all of this uncertainty? And Paul says to them, you need to rejoice every day. You need to pray always. And you need to give thanks. And I'm sure the people then and the people now, we say, how? You know, how am I supposed to always feel happy? And, you know, how am I supposed to feel good about these things that seem to be so troubling to my soul? I mean, you know, this is some serious stuff that's going on. If you read the newspaper with any sense of integrity, you know, there's some serious stuff going on in the world. But Paul didn't say go be happy. That's not what he was saying. He was saying find joy. And where do we find our joy? You know, we find our joy in the Lord. This is this third Sunday of Advent is Gaudete, G-A-U-D-E-T-E, which comes from the Latin, and it's pulled from Philippians 4, 4 through 6. Rejoice in the Lord, rejoice in the Lord, always. But it's that word rejoice, and it is the Sunday that we are called to recognize that our joy comes from the Lord. And it's not that just superficial happy feeling because something good happens to us in the moment, because those things are fleeting. It is that kind of deep down inner joyful experience we have because we understand what it is that Mark was really talking about last week when he says, this is the beginning of the good news. And the beginning of the good news is that Jesus Christ came, and Jesus Christ is God's Son. And you know why Jesus Christ came? He came to save us. And that is good news for you, and that is good news for me, because when Jesus Christ came to save us, there was an intention on God's part to make sure that we would be okay, that no matter how life goes in this earthly plane, no matter how the world just not, you know, people aren't being nice to each other, and things aren't going perfectly as we had hoped, and we're not always healthy and well, and we may not always have all the money we want, but no matter how all that's going, we have a higher power that we pay homage to, and that higher power is the power where our heart goes to, and that higher power is where we will find our joy. And in Christ, we can feel that experience of inner joy and excitement. And I can tell you over and over again through all the years that I have served as a pastor, when I go to visit people who are quite sick, I have conversations, and I can always tell those people that have a deep relationship with the Lord, because no matter what their physical experiences are, there is that peace and that calm and that joy because they understand who God is and who they are, and things are going to be all right. It may not be all right on this plane, and it may not be going exactly as they had hoped or their family had hoped, but they understand where they're going, and there are going to be better days ahead. And so even in that moment, when their bodies aren't feeling that good, there is still joy in their spirit. Because that's where we really live, folks. You know, all the stuff that's happening on the outside, It's just stuff that's happening on the outside. And so why is Pastor Maria talking about this on the third Sunday of Advent? Because we have time yet. We have a whole week before Easter comes. Woo! Okay. I do this every year, don't I? God bless me. We have a whole week before Christmas comes. And in this whole week before Christmas comes, let's be an Easter people. Let's be a people who believe that we serve the one who came to save us. And if we serve the one who came to save us, then we're not, you know, those wonderful Hallmark movies that we are all absolutely crazy about and we turn on and we ooey-gooey about, and it wouldn't be lovely if our houses looked like that and our families behave like that for 2 seconds, not 2 hours, 2 seconds. Our families won't. But you know what? It wasn't like that in the stable 2,000 years ago. I was talking to the preschoolers last week. It was stinky where Jesus was born. Oh, they laughed. They thought that was really funny. I went, pew, it was stinky. But it was, because that's where the animals lived. You know, they went there and they were eating their hay, and they were out in the fields all day. It wasn't smelling all pretty. When Mary laid him down in that manger in that little creche area, it wasn't all beautiful and pretty and clean and sweet smelling. But there was joy in that moment, because the one who had been promised to us had come into the world. Because the love of God was going to fill the world to overflowing, so that the people of God would know that God would do anything for us. And that's the joy we get to spread this week. When everybody else is online and grumbling, we don't have to be those people, because we know the God we serve. And when we're at the grocery store and people are fussing about the thing that's not on the shelf, we don't have to worry about it. Because it doesn't matter if it's not the perfect ingredient. It could be the second ingredient, and it could be just as good. Because the joy that we feel about this time of year is about the people whose eyes we get to look into, and the stories we get to share about our childhood and our memories, and the memories that they share with us, and about the love that we have for one another, and the God who came to save us, and the times that we will have into the future to continue spreading the good news of Jesus Christ. And this is who we are called to be. People who live joy in the Lord. People who love the Lord as the Lord loves us. And so your challenge for this week is to be an ambassador for Christ, because that's what Paul was. He was out there all the time. He went to all those other places where none of the other apostles wanted to go. You know, he didn't go to those nice places. He went to all those Gentiles who didn't know God, and he told them about God, and they got so excited that they were worried that he wasn't coming back fast enough. Well, if you're worried he's not coming back fast enough, it's because God wants everybody to know him. And so let's not worry. Let's just have joy in the Lord. Let's spread the good news of Jesus Christ. Let us spread that joy in the places we go this week, so that others might come to understand there's something about serving God and being a follower of Jesus Christ. Not by the presents we put under the tree or all the perfect decorations or how clean our floors are. Mine are not clean this week. That didn't get on the list. And this won't be the perfect year for all the presents under the tree or the cards being written. But it is my commitment to God that I will go out, and whenever I'm out, I will be God's light. I pray that you take up the challenge to be an ambassador for Christ, to spread the joy of Christ, because Christ is coming. Amen.